Handicapper Steve here, handicapping the racing from 40 Racetrack here on Tuesday. It is July the 23rd, 2019. I'm going to look the 8th race from 40, but before I get on to that, remember to please follow me on Twitter at HorseRacingKit5 for more selections for race courses around the world, and join me this Saturday for my Saratoga Jim Dandy preview video. And if you're interested in the races from England, on Saturday from Ascot, you have the King George, which is always a great race. So join me here on YouTube for that. But let's get to the 8th race from 40, which is the second leg of the Canadian Triple Crown. The 8th race, it is the Prince of Wales Stakes purse $400,000 races for 3-year-old Canadian foals here. Field of 5 horses going the distance of a ground of 1,900 meters, if you want to go with that, with a distance of ground of 3/16 on the Fort Erie main track. 1,900, 3/16. And I show the diagram, just gives me that little extra second to look down my notes, just bear with me. But my top selection, I'm going to try and beat the favorite here, and I'm going to use the 5-horse Skywire. He's 3-1, but I think it'll run well. I'll go 5-2-1 in the Tri-Cash Trifecta. 5-2-1 Trifecta, top selection, the 5-horse Skywire. This 3-0 colt by Fleet Alex, who actually won the second leg of the American Triple Crown in 2005, the Preakness at Pimlico, but that's for another day. Mark Cassie trains. Enrico De Rosa Silva gets the leg up. The horse's most recent out came 28th of June at Woodbine, mile quarter on the Tapeta and the Queen's Plate, and the horse finished 11th by 19 1/4 lengths that day, and didn't have the best of starts at all. Actually had a crap start, got knocked down almost, and he just had to check a few times, had a horrible trip, was drawn wide. He had more of a trip that day. You know, I'm gonna throw that race out. If he could show his form sitting closer today, back to the races before, I think he's sitting on a good run. Just go watch the replay and you'll understand why he didn't get into the Queen's Plate last time out. And he was the 2-1 favorite. Before that though, in the Marine at Woodbine, mile 16th, May 25th, he finished second by length. He was very wide that day, but he closed up well. He ran a good second that afternoon, and then the 28th of April at Woodbine, mile 16th in the Wando, he won by 2.5 lengths. He stalked early on, he got the lead, and then he just took off clear. I would like to see him sit a little bit closer today, because it looks like there could be a little bit of lack of speed. If he runs the race like the Wando, he wins this race very easily. He has started on the dirt once before. That came on the 13th of February at Gulfstream Park, mile and 1/16 off the turf, and an optional 75 claimer. First time facing winners, he did everything right. He won by 6 lengths. Well, he almost did everything right. He didn't break all that well, because he hit the gate going out of it, but he sat back, he had a great turn of foot, and he won quite decisively. A very good run. Then they took this horse to the Jeff Ruby Stakes at Turfway, going a mile away from the Poly Track, where he finished 8th by 9 1/4 lengths and just had nothing, and also had a horrible trip. He's the kind of horse that seems to find his trips, but when he gets a clear trip, he wins very easily. I'm going to give him another shot here. His most recent workout on the dirt has been very fast. 3-1, watch out for him. So to recount my selection for the 8th from Fort Erie, it is the Prince of Wales Stakes. Let's take the 5-horse Skywire. We'll go 5-2-1 in the Tri-Cash Trifecta. So good luck to him. Please follow me on Twitter at HorseRacingKit5. Good luck, everybody.